The last time we ever met. But I know the reason why you keep your silence up. No, you don't fool me. That doesn't show, but the pain still grows. So stranger to you.
Like a hero on a history book. trade your baseball cap for a crown. And they gave us our trophies, and we held them up for our town. And the cynics were outraged, screaming, this is absurd.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated.
Good evening. Members of the school board, administration, faculty, family, and friends, welcome to our class night ceremony. Please join us in celebration of our memories and accomplishments. Although the memory making was cut a bit short due to COVID-19, this is not a time to sulk about the past and what we had missed due to the circumstances of these hard times. Instead, let's rejoice about what we were able to do this year. This comes with a special thanks to all who have helped us to try to have a real senior year experience. Let's focus on the past memories we have made that we will never forget and always cherish as the Carbondale Area Class of 2021.
Welcome to Class Night 2021. Even though our senior year wasn't all that fun, it sure turned out to be a memorable one. Because of COVID-19, the majority of our senior year wasn't to be seen. Going back to school a couple days a week took some getting used to, but seeing my friends was worth it. That's if they were in the same cohort as you. Our fall sports season wasn't able to be played, but we were also happy to hear that the winter and spring sports would not be delayed. Even though playing games was challenging with masks to wear, and sometimes wins were pretty rare, we were thankful to the school board for letting our athletes shine through the sports they love once more. Since most of this year happened to be a blur, our previous years I would much rather prefer. Starting as far back as seventh grade, the Instagram of Skelly Fabio was made. Anthony and I would sneak in just to get pictures of him and his skeleton twin. Our best friend Trish always knew we were there when she heard a knock at her window and a peek of Gianna's red hair. Miss Bailey's felt bad because of our cut short year, so she told us she had news that she couldn't wait to hear. She said she wanted to do us a favor, so she invited us back so we could dissect old Major. Well, Major takes us back to Animal Farm when we read about pigs taking over a barn. Next, Mr. Perry taught us about mice, where he added to the characters a little bit of spice. We begged him to do one last impression of Lenny, but he wouldn't budge, not for even a penny. Instead, he let Billy discuss his issues through the use of our friend who sat next to the tissues. The dinosaur who hid with Lenny under the brush accompanied Billy to help him discuss. Together, they showed their complete hatred for the potato famine where no one made it. My favorite part of walking to chemistry involved a backpack and Gianna yelling at me. We all would attach to her like glue until we reached the door, which we struggled to get through. Back in 10th grade, we thought we had it made. We even had a trip to Kalahari, but we didn't know that we were soon to find out that our ride home would be a safari. Miss Olivetti drove the war wagon when all of a sudden something happened. A little mouse decided to pay a visit after jumping out of the glove compartment to come sit. After this, we weren't too fond of Carbondale's pets until we began raising some in our own incubator sets. Here we began to grow as a class as we watched our water-growing animals grow up so fast. We all worked very hard throughout our high school years that will take us to graduation, which will bring us smiles and tears. It is time to bring our Chargers days to an end. The class of 2021 will soon go out with a hoop, but for now, all we have to say is
before we start, a brief explanation about this series of poems, our own creation.
We've been writing presentations the past 2 weeks. We've hit some valleys, we've climbed some peaks.
We're aware our grammar needs some correction, but entertainment was our goal, not perfection.
Our periods and commas may be out of place. Perhaps our pronouns are in the wrong case.
All we've written has been done in jest. Shakespeare we aren't, but we've tried our best.
We used and abused poetic license to the limit, even more than our sponsors care to permit it.
The thing about this that we find so weird, we didn't have to do it, we volunteered.
Some of our jokes you may not get, but our classmates will. On that you can bet.
So bear with us as we read each one, relax, enjoy, and have some fun.
Michael Bosick. Michael, your love for the Steelers cannot be topped, always bragging to Mr. Foote how they will never be stopped. So wear this around in all your glory and pride, even if it will make Mr. Foote cry.
Alexandria Brennan. Alex, I heard you like Paw Patrol the show. You may be a bit too old for toys, though. This pup, however, can help you remember the sky is the limit, something to hold on to forever.
Jaheim Brooker. Jaheim, you're probably tired of people saying you're tall, but you'll never get tired of going out the ball.
Natalie Brown. Natalie, we know you like to paint in class, so here's a set to make it last. Keep making art and have a blast.
Thank you.
Olivia Christian. Olivia, we all know you're great at cleaning, going place to place, doing housekeeping. I got you some Clorox wipes for your own business, the one and only OC's Cleaning Service.
Michael Cornell. Now, Mike, I know you like working with cars. However, I got one for you that won't go very far. I hope you enjoy these brand new wheels. Take it for a ride and see how it feels.
Hector Acosta. Hector, everyone calls you Pickles, so I put together some nickels to get you this jar for the one and only track star.
Anthony Adams. AJ, not many people know you're a firefighter, and I heard you're low, man, so there's room to go higher. We got you a badge so you don't feel left out, and good luck controlling that water spout.
Natea Anderson. Natea, it was back in seventh grade the last time I saw you. Thinking back how long ago that was didn't seem true. You're very smart in school that people give you compliments, so here's a gift to congratulate you on your accomplishments.
Nakia Andadora. Nakia, throughout the years, makeup has always been your thing. Each day we would look forward to seeing the new look you would bring. In honor of that, we got you this palette and hope to see you thrive showing off your talent.
Seth Bazink. Seth, you like to fish and hunt, so I challenge you to pull this stunt. Next time you're looking to get a buck, use this bow and give your Instagram followers a real show.
Joshua Gifford. Josh. Thank you for always holding the door. Hopefully with this door stop, you won't have to do it anymore.
Gianna Gillette. Gianna, I know you like to cheer on the team. Every season you could be seen. In the bleachers or on the court, you were there to cheer on and support. So here are some palms to always remember the CA cheer team as a beloved member.
Kaylin Green. You attended CTC for culinary arts, so I got you the spatula before we depart. On your journey through life, you can use this to cook and revisit the info from the classes you took.
Bailey Grisani. Bailey, we all know you're good at math, so I got you some books you can read in the bath. You might think these problems are a little too easy, however, it'll make your college life easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Matthew Patrick Heenan. Matt. You spent 6 hours in the parlor. You probably wanted to leave, so I got you this better tattoo to finish your sleeve.
Shaquille Hoskins. Shaquille, I've heard you like to bust some moves, so here's a disco ball to take with you. No matter where you choose to dance, don't be afraid, just take a chance.
Robert Cron. Robbie, you always had your strong curly hair, which wasn't fair. For your future classmates who sit behind you in class, here's a hair tie so you could put your hair up at last.
Athen to Furia. Athen. Racing down roads always seems like a blast. The adrenaline rush is thrilling, but that's not how to make a car last. I know you may think that driving fast is fun, so we got you a toy car in hopes that you may be able to take care of this one.
Connor Eibach. Connor, you were never really the best when it came to sports involving a ball. Reaper's Revenge was the only place we were able to find you in the fall. That's where you told people they were in luck and said a story about a rubber duck. So here's your own, even though we are grown.
Sydney Eichenbaum. Sydney, whether it's a different hair color today or different makeup the next, take this hair dye so you can add to your supply so we know you're always looking your best.
Juliana Galarza. Juliana, eighth grade exploring tech class is where it all began. Mr. Gilpin was the teacher and you were his biggest fan. Although Mr. Gilpin may no longer be here, he left you with memories so near and dear. We got you his picture so you can never forget. Just look and laugh whenever you're upset.
Caitlin Kilmer. Since you're the queen of twirling, I got you this crown, throwing your baton in the air, never hitting the ground. Use this to display you're the best in your class for all of CI history, never to be surpassed.
Chloe Livingston. Chloe, I heard that you damaged your Jeep, so I got you one you can hopefully keep. This one is in the form of a sign. I hope you like our new design.
Donovan Loomis. Donovan, if you want to play football, your bones must be big and strong as silk, so to keep that good structure, I got you some milk.
Brielle Marchion. Brielle, don't go to college and take the risk. Be prepared and carry this whisk.
Joseph Mark. Joey. Getting your homework done on time was never your thing, so I got you this journal with its very own string. So write down your plans wherever you go, that way you'll never forget and always will know.
Melina McCormick. Melina, I got you a gift that you can wear all day, or keep it on, or if you want, keep it on display. I know the Eagles are your favorite team. When you wear it, your eyes are sure to gleam.
Michael Hudson. Mike, you always love your cars and Fords, even the collection they have in stores. To add to your collection, here's a toy truck for your succession.
Mackenzie Carafa. Mackenzie, we all know you're best when it comes to riding your horse while it's running and galloping through the course. To many of us, you may seem quiet and shy, but it's very important for us to send you off with a memorable goodbye. We got you a figurine of a horse. Never forget it came from this source.
Aiden Kelly. Aiden. If anyone saw you at prom, they know you would not let the party be stopped. Your singing and dancing will never be topped. Here's some earbuds for when the next beat is dropped.
Ooh, these are coming neat.
Nala O'Dowd. Nala, you missed your last season because of this terrible year, so I got you some pom-poms so you never forget how to cheer.
Raymond Offner. Raymond, you make me nervous when you drive real fast, but you have to keep up the speed because if you ain't first, you're last.
Richard Pacheco. Wherever you're seen, no matter where you go, you always have headphones and everyone knows. I got you an extra pair so that without a doubt, you'll always have a pair when you're out and about.
Shane Phillips. Shane, I got you a gift you can take on the go, you can use it in the future, and even fill it with a cup of joe.
Eric Richard Prafke. Eric, you probably didn't want to get hit. I guess it was just your fate. You should have put on your seatbelt and helmet. Oh no, too late.
Gianelli Prieto. Gianelli, although your handwriting may be small, everyone knows how neat it is. You'll always be remembered as a handwriting whiz.
Morgana McGee. Morgana, you always kept a stash in your bag full of treats, the kind of candy that will break your teeth. Here's some Jolly Ranchers to sunk on in the future. Hope the rest of your life is super.
Aaron McHale. Aaron, all the way back to elementary school, your most memorable trait was the big bows that everyone thought were so cool. You had a new one to wear day after day, every color of the rainbow and even gray. Although you may not wear it today, we got you a bow so you will never forget your childhood ways.
Destiny McKeever. Destiny. Danny would always call you Dez. You always have a smile on your face no matter what anybody says. Your nails always impress, so here's some press-ons. Keep them looking their best.
Thank you. Jose Mendez. Jay Schmoney. At the end of the day, football and basketball are your thing. But you know taking care of your hair tops it all. We got you a brush next time it's messed up on the jump ball.
Christina Morales. Christina. Your hair was always so long, it shut on my desk and I didn't know where it belonged. Here are some hair clips to keep your hair together, to keep your hair off people's desks forever.
Joanna Munoz. Joanna, it all started in Spanish with our friend named Cheese. We would all ask you what words meant and you would respond with ease. You wanted a nickname like others in the class, so we named you Pollo and you didn't want to pass. The name has stuck throughout the years, so here's a little chicken to always remember your high school peers.
Hallie Schwartz. Hooli. You were always the go-to whenever I needed gum, all different flavors, which was so much fun. Now it's time to show off your swag with this gumball machine to clip on your bag.
Carmine Torrey. Carmine, I heard you like to watch WWE. You watch it very often. So here's a gift for you from me, a picture of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Julian Taronis. Julian, you are a great artist. There's no question about that. Hopefully with the sketch pad, you'll always know where your drawings are at.
Ariel Williamson. Ariel, everyone knows you worked at Burger King down the road. Your talent serving food has always showed, although you now work at Taco Bell, wear this tag to remember it well.
Aviana Puglisi. Avi, your number two, making prosthetics, is what you plan to do. Superheroes come to mind when we think of you. So here's this cape for when reality is something you want to escape.
Brandon Ratliff. Brandon, I hear you enjoy your horses and fighting fires, but you also have some other desires. Since being a firefighter is your strong suit, we got you a pager so you can stay in pursuit.
Alex Richardson. Alex, your creativity and art fascinated me as you drew on the sides of your paper with glee. Here's a sketchbook for all your ideas on board. I hope you use this gift as a reward.
Dynasty Romero. Dynasty, many of us may not know you all that well, so I reached out to some classmates to see if anything would ring a bell. I was informed that you were vegan, and that gave me a clue of where to begin. I'm not really sure what you can or can't eat, so I did some research and found it neat. Here's a vegan-friendly snack to remember your classmates will always have your back.
Sarah Tallarico. Sarah, I've decided to get this Xbox for you. Now you can play it when there's nothing to do. Take this home and call up Owen. It's time to play Fortnite. You better get going.
Anula Connolly. Yanni, I hope you take this gift with you next year. That way forgetting homework will not be your fear. You can write it down day after day and just think of you saying, gee, was there homework today?
Olivia Liuzzo. Olivia, walking through the woods will give you wet socks. You'll never have to worry if you're wearing your Crocs.
Amelia Muda. Amelia, I know CVS is kept in your heart very dear, so here is a frame to keep as a souvenir. At CVS, you may find bandages and bubble wrap of any kind. Some may know you fell and bumped your head, too many stairs can land you in bed. Just in case you happen to take another tumble, this first aid kit will be there to help with your trouble.
Maria Sarah. Most people hate bad gifts, like underwear or socks, so I one-upped those and got you this poster of Tupac.
Ethan Totsky. Harold, we all know your favorite saying, so I got you this gift. I hope you start playing. This gift is quite a steal. You might even say that it is unreal.
Olivia Chavone. Liv, everyone here knows your love for chicken. This kind, though, isn't so finger-licking. So when you're alone with no one to talk to, just squeeze this chicken and he will respond to you.
Cassidy Bruin. Cass, if you said this was something you would deny, we all know it would be a lie. Here's a coupon for a free small McDonald's fry.
Dina Mancuso. Dina, to be honest, I wrote this poem at midnight on Monday and had no idea what to say. But I know you like basketball. I got you one so you could continue to play.
Taylor Mazza. Taylor, it was sophomore year when you used an eyelash curler. Having one naked eye was cooler. You ripped your lashes from using the curler, Ron, so here's a pair of fake lashes that you should have used all along.
Anthony Mastika. Aunt, Blueberry Hill has always been your passion, planting and making sure everything was done in orderly fashion. Rain or shine, that's where we can find you, so here's a plant to hold on to make sure you don't leave the class of 21 behind you.
Gianna Ernies. Gianna, at lunch you have different snacks every day to keep you motivated and special containers to keep your food separated. There has been a nickname we have called you for years. Hopefully this box of Cheez-Its won't rush down any tears.
William Kovaleski. Bill, not everyone knows, but you always use your mom's clothes to put on the best fashion shows. You also entertained us by letting your emotions roar while we passed around Mr. Perry's dinosaur. Here's a new one to adore.
Amelia Esgro. Ezzy, I couldn't decide if you like golf or basketball more, so I thought back to Advanced Bio and got you a growable dinosaur.
Have come and gone. What a journey we've been on.
Tonight we will remember the past, and also we hope to share a few laughs.
These things were willed out of pure fun. We hope you enjoy them and are not offended when we are done.
We the class of 2021, being of sound minds and dedicated bodies, do solemnly swear this our last testament.
Olivia Chavone wills her basketball skills to Sadie Gardas.
Nate Totsky wills his unreal fishing and hunting skills to his brother, Matt Totsky.
Maria Serra wills her silly TikToks to Elizabeth Pantoja.
Amelia Muda wills her CVS parking spot to Ellie Higdon, although no one can replace Rashonda.
Olivia Liuzzo wills her Harry Styles earrings to Chloe Rumford.
Anula Connolly wills taking care of Miss Bailey's animals to Mia Perry.
Sarah Tallarico wills her Heelys to Mia Marrero. Just watch out for Mr. Foot.
Michael Bosick wills his love of the Steelers to Mr. Foot. We know you need a new team to root for.
Alex Brennan wills her amazing dance moves to Luke Bradley.
Jaheim Brooker wills his height to Preston Casey. We know you could use a few inches.
Natalie Brown wills her artistic abilities to Rosemarie Navarrete.
Olivia Christian wills her blue eyes to Madison Regal.
Michael Cornell wills his knowledge of cars to Leah Misko.
Josh Gifford wills his kindness to Alexis Price.
Gianna Gillette wills her job at McDonald's to Dakota Beater.
Kaylin Green wills her kind heart to Casey Bannon.
Bailey Grisani wills his face to Carbondale area. If you know, you know.
John Baker wills his ginger hair color to Madison Heenan.
Rico Barrios wills his earrings to Killian Bannon.
Devin Boston wills his speaker to anyone who can handle it, but don't play it too loud.
Kayleen Castro wills her makeup skills to Sophia Calzola.
Philip DeBerry wills his adventurous side to Nick Omlock.
Justine Fashauer wills her job at Weiss to Jonathan Purvis.
Shane Grunzel wills his gamer skills to Bryson Kelly.
London Case wills her selfie-taking skills to Haley Paterka.
Angel LaVere wills his jokes to Chase Arthur.
Bradley Marsh wills his apple-throwing skills to Noah Kilmer.
Sue-Ann Moran wills her love of books to Mackenzie Spade.
Isaiah Petrisky wills his interesting impressions to Mr. Perry.
Brandon Seminago wills his humor to Gavin Heenan.
Xavier Sopko wills his talks with Mrs. Hughes to Justin Toy.
Ronald Umstead wills his skateboard to Victoria Pagan.
Alexia Vandermark wills her job at Frank's to Emma Perry.
Matt Heenan wills his baseball glove to Liam Shanice.
Tyler Warmoth wills his helping hand to Caden Brennan.
Caitlin Kilmer wills her position as lead twirler to Sarah Perry.
Chloe Livingston wills her love of quad riding to her sister Jocelyn Livingston.
Donovan Loomis wills his cowboy hat to Mikey Yasinovich.
Brielle Marchione wills her culinary skills to Emily Kelly.
Joey Mark wills his football position to Alex McCann.
Melina McCormick wills her bad case of senioritis to Alyssa Shaw. We know you've started early.
Nala O'Dowd wills her pom-poms to Alyssa Coslow.
Raymond Offner wills his love of sports to Vinny DePalma.
Richard Pacheco wills his music taste to Jacob Ulmer.
Shane Phillips wills his love of coffee to McKenna Sanderson.
Eric Prafke wills his luscious hair to Brian Solitsky.
Gianelli Prieto wills her perfect handwriting to Emma Baker.
Hallie Schwartz wills her sarcasm to Logan Warmoth.
Carmine Torrey wills his hall pass to Kiefer Wies. Don't take 20 minutes.
Julian Taronis wills his spot as teacher's pet to Madeline Borders.
Ariel Williamson wills her love for Hello Kitty to Autumn Cruz.
The class of 2021 wills hiding Jobo Claus to the class of 2022. You have big shoes to fill with that one.
Mr. Perry's fifth period English class in 2019 wills the dinosaur to the upcoming sophomore class, if you could find it.
We will these things to keep our legacy alive as our time to depart soon arrives.
Standing here waiting to go, our paths seem unclear, but we will be ready without any fear.
After we leave, we are bound to grow apart, but we will keep our classmates close to the heart.
Signed and sealed on this 9th day of June in the year 2021, Taylor Mazza
and Dina Mancuso.
The year 2041, the place, the infamous Carbondale Grand Hotel, the purpose, the 20th class reunion for Carbondale area class of 2021. As the scene for the evening is set, our classmates begin to arrive. Pulling up in their Uber, driven by Athan DeFuria, is Nakia Andadora, who is cleaning up her spilled makeup brushes off the floor, and Brandon Ratliff, who is on the phone taking care of some work issues that only the head manager of Weiss can solve. They are, in fact, early. As they walk in, Athan explains that his dream was to be a NASCAR driver, but after some words of encouragement from speech professor Robert Cron, he decided it was too dangerous. Next to arrive is the well-off psychology professor Connor Ibach, who had been dropped off by his limousine driver, Jaden Smith. All of a sudden, a parrot flies into the room, and it's followed by its trainer, Tiara Kialoa Silva, who is getting some pointers on how to properly train an animal from an animal shelter activist, Clarice Winters.
Dashing in while still in her princess costume from a last-minute Disney performance is Erin McHale. She is followed by her hairstylist, Destiny McKeever, and makeup artist, London Case. They are trying their best to help Erin get herself ready for the evening. Already seated at table number one is History Museum owner Aiden Kelly, who is in a discussion with Quad Company owner Michael Hudson about which of the exhibits in the museum is his favorite. They are joined by author Crystal Yarborough, who is discussing her latest novel with fellow writer Jane Medina and illustrator Alex Richardson. Morgan Pinella adds to the discussion by explaining how she reads their books to the children at her daycare. Their conversation is interrupted when their turkey dinner, caught by hunter Seth Bazink, is brought out by five-star restaurant owner Trevor Wenzel and nutritionist Dynasty Romero.
Seated at table two are mechanics Eric Gardner, Gavin Lomerson, and Matthew Ennis, who have a company together called Get Her Done. They are joined by kindergarten teachers Joanna Munoz and Christina Morales. They are currently in discussion about their lesson they are teaching together. Canoeing instructor Anthony Adams was talking about his recent canoe mishap with weeds, while Anthony Mastica, greenhouse owner, was explaining what kind of weeds they were.
Running extremely late was Jose Mendez, Jay Money, who had just got back from scouting someone for his basketball team. He forgot his comb, but he did remember his speaker. Entering later was the person who cured COVID, Dina Mancuso, who is also known as the next Meredith Grey, and Aviana Puglisi, the new Albert Einstein, who were being escorted into the room by bodyguard Frank Beater. Walking around the room was watch enthusiast William Kovaleski, who was showing off his latest Rolex. Following him was dentist Taylor Mazza, who was passing out floss to her fellow classmates.
Sitting at table number three is Gianna Arnis, who is currently working with Big League Sports Team and looking to have professional softball player Cassidy Bruin on her team. Next to them sits Amelia Esgro, who is discussing the important vitamins athletes should take to stay healthy and the supplements that should be banned. Professional golfer Tommy Suzalco jumps in, discussing how chicken nuggets should also be prohibited on and off the golf course for choking hazards, of course. Olympic gold medalist Hector Acosta listens into the conversation while writing Amelia Esgro's tips down on a napkin so that he's prepared and energized for his next race.
Seated at table number four is Abigail Bonacci and Devin Barrows, who discuss their recent win on their volleyball team. Painter Andrew Bouchard sits quietly sketching a design that makeup artist Kayla Cobb loves and plans to recreate a makeup look inspired by that design. Best friends and actors Caitlin Hudson, Peter Howie, and Steven Stolarik reminisce on their last play together, directed by Juliana Galarza. Video gamer Kenny Rott sits quietly on his phone trying to finish his latest game, while convenient owner Anthony Giacobino asks him to sponsor his new brand of chips.
Standing together is farm owner Mackenzie Carafa, student instructor at the farm Natea Anderson, and hairstylist Sydney Eichenbaum. They talk about their plans on the farm while Sydney thinks about the next color she's going to dye the horse's hair. Running across the room is Isaiah Easter screaming fire. He had tipped over the candle and now the tablecloth is on fire. Quickly, we call the fire department and chief firefighter Morgana McGee sprints in to save us all from disaster.
The night ends as we dance with each other and create the memories we longed for our senior year. The workers at the hotel are sad to see us go, but we promise them we'll be back in another 10 years to continue on with the celebration.
And congratulations to the class of 2021. Jack Rossler was a youth sports advocate for many years in the Carbondale community and passed away suddenly at age 38. He was a manager for the Carbondale Little League, active in the Carbondale Junior Football Program, as well as a coach in the youth basketball leagues. To say that Jack was passionate about athletics is an understatement. The Jack Rossler Scholarship has been awarded for the past 34 years. Tonight, this will be the 34th and final time for the Jack Rossler Scholarship. Over the years, more than $30,000 has been awarded to Carbondale area graduates. On behalf of Jack's wife, Kathy Rossler Coos, his children, Sean and Bumper, and the entire Rossler family, it is my honor and privilege to present this year's scholarships to Hallie Swartz and Raymond Offner. Next is the Tom Tiny Molinaro Scholarship. Tom Molinaro was a volunteer assistant football coach here at Carbondale area. Tom was also an EMT for our local cottage hose company. And before the days of full-time athletic trainers, due to his love for the game of football, Tom would work his shift at cottage hose ambulance and come right to the school to provide treatment at practice if a need would arise. He became a valuable member of our football program for many years. On behalf of the Molinaro family, it is my honor and privilege to present this year's Tom Tiny Molinaro Scholarship to Raymond Offner. Next is the Mike Red Wallace Scholarship. Red Wallace was a Simpson resident who coached the Elk Lake Warriors to two state basketball championship appearances, including a state title in 1977. Despite being very ill with cancer, he guided his 1977 team to a state crown, but passed away just a few months later. Coincidentally, his 1977 championship team played their state title game before our very own Carbondale area Chargerettes and their 1977 state title in Hershey. In addition, Red Wallace was an original member of the Boston Celtics. On behalf of the Wallace family, it's my honor and privilege to present this year's Mike Red Wallace Scholarship to Raymond Offner. The PIAA Scholar Athlete Award is given to the student athlete with the highest academic average that participated in two or more sports for 3 or more years. This year's recipients are Sarah Tallarico and Bailey Grisanti.
Samir. Congratulations, graduates. I know it's been a less than ideal learning environment the last year, but I applaud you for your accomplishments. Katie and I are here to present the Stephen Brownell Memorial Scholarship in honor of my brother and Katie's uncle, Stephen Brownell. It's been hard to believe it's been over 35 years since he's graduated from Carbondale Area High School. But some of the requirements of this scholarship emulate the life that Stephen lived, which were he had to participate in at least 2 varsity sports during your 4-year career at Carbondale area. And also, it was important that you participated in community service as Stephen did. So given these requirements and the applicants that applied, we are thrilled to announce that this year's recipient, which is a $1,000 scholarship to the school of their choice, is Gianna Arnese.
And then
I'm here to present the scholarship this year in honor of my late son, Andrew. This scholarship has been made possible by the abundance of support and generosity throughout the local communities and by the Andrew Mazza Foundation. I would also like to thank Carbondale Area School District for the opportunity to do so. Our scholarship this year is based on character. What is it and why it's so important in our everyday lives? I would like to award this year's Andrew Mazza Scholarship to Sarah Tallarico.
Thank you. I appreciate this opportunity to award the scholarship in my mother's name. First, I'd like to say congratulations to the class of 2021. Sorry. Particularly to her grandson, Aiden. The whole family couldn't be more proud. Now, I realize the students on this stage and graduating in the next few days weren't even born when my mom made that difficult decision to retire and focus on her battle with cancer and spend her remaining time with her family enjoying her soon-to-be grandchildren. So I'd like to take a few minutes to tell you a little bit about her to help you understand why my father, who unfortunately couldn't be here tonight, decided to establish this scholarship in her name. Many of her parents can vouch for me when I tell you that she was a hardworking and dedicated teacher who spent over 20 years of her long teaching career here at Carbondale area. She taught a variety of math classes, from Title I remedial math to Algebra II to AP Calculus. She had a passion for math and an even larger passion for teaching her students about it. She gave up countless prep periods, lunches, and frequently stayed after school to help any student who needed extra time or attention. She took so much pride when that light bulb went off with her students. Don't get me wrong, she was a tough and demanding teacher, but she encouraged her students to challenge themselves, work hard, and always just do their best. Because of this dedication, our family felt the most appropriate award and a good way to honor her memory would be to award the student with the highest grades in honors math through their 4 years in high school with the Diane Kelly Math Excellence Award. This year, the recipient of the Diane Kelly Memorial Math Award is Bailey Grisani.
Good evening, and congratulations to the class of 2021. My name is Nathan Masco, and I'm here this evening representing the Carbondale Chapter of Unico National to present the Unico National Scholarship. The Carbondale Chapter of Unico National was created on June 6, 1959, and is a nationwide service organization which is non-political and non-sectarian. Its membership is made up of Italian Americans or those married to Italian Americans. In Italian, the word Unico means only one of a kind. Each letter in the word represents qualities demonstrated by its members: unity, neighborliness, integrity, charity, and opportunity to serve. Over the years, our membership has seen the many good qualities demonstrated by the youth of our city, and this scholarship provides us a way to demonstrate how proud we are of them. Our scholarship is given each year in memory of one of our past members, the late Dominic Spike Mazza, an advocate for our youth throughout his lifetime. It is with great pleasure I announce this year's Carbondale Unico Scholarship winners, Gianna Arnese and Sarah Tallarico. Congratulations.
Good evening. First and foremost, I'd like to offer a very big congratulations to the whole class here for making it through an extremely challenging year. To get to this point is definitely exceptional. Many challenges you've had to go over through this whole year. And parents too. My name is Beth Derwin. I'm an officer with the Business and Professional Women's Organization of Carbondale. The organization has been around for 81 years, not only serving women's interests, but also doing great works for the community. Each year we pick a scholarship recipient, one who's interested in going forward in the medical career. And this year, our recipient that we'd like to acknowledge is Taylor Mazza.
Good evening. I'm Brian Delaney, adjutant of the Simpson VFW Post 4712. I am joined today by our commander, Ed Matice, and we're here today to present the 2021 Walter Pazizia Scholarship, which is awarded to a graduating senior or seniors who completes an essay titled, How Have Veterans Made an Impact in My Life? This essay is then read by our membership and ranked from first place onward. This year, we had five outstanding essays to choose from. The Post was tasked with a difficult decision to pick a major winner and four minor winners from these essays. This proved to be daunting, as every essay was remarkable in their own way. But in the end, they all won the hearts and minds of the Post and Auxiliary. For our minor recipients, they are Sarah Tallarico, Cassidy Bruin, Dina Mancuso, and Taylor Mazza. I am very pleased now to announce our major 2021 winner of the Walter Pazizia Scholarship, Aviana Puglisi. In Aviana's essay, she talks about her father, Sergeant First Class George Puglisi, who paid the ultimate sacrifice on a very hot September day in 2005 in Anabar, Providence, city of Ramadi, Iraq. I remember that day well. It's something that I will never forget. In her essay, Aviana wrote, quote, I am proud to say that my dad was a real-life superhero. His sacrifice and those of others will never be forgotten, unquote. Well, Aviana, your dad is a superhero. One that I admire as well. Most of what I learned as a young private in the U.S. Army was taught to me by your father. He is and was one of the best men I have yet to know. Congratulations to all of our winners, and congratulations to the Carbondale Class of 2021. May you all go on to do great things for yourselves and this great nation. Thank you all for your support. Good evening.
Good evening. Congratulations, class of 2021. I'm here tonight to award two scholarships from the 109th Infantry Regiment Association. Our organization was founded with the mission of remembering the men and women who served with the 109th Infantry, to support our wounded warriors, and most importantly, to pay our highest respect to our fallen soldiers and to honor their memory through our Gold Star families. Our first award will go to Haley Swartz. Congratulations, Haley, on being selected to receive our Legacy Scholarship Award. On behalf of our association, the Scholarship Committee, and the legacy of your grandfather, Albert Swartz, who I personally served with, we wish you well in your pursuit of higher education. Work hard, never give up, and focus on your goal of higher education. Remember what you have endured and what you have worked for, and never forget the legacy of your 109th Infantry Regiment family member. Our second award recipient is Aviana Puglisi. Aviana, I personally served with your father and deployed with him to Ramadi, Iraq in 2005. Most of our 180 members knew him and served with him. We are all brothers and sisters when we serve our country, and we form an unbroken bond to one another. This bond goes beyond friendship. This bond is truly a brotherhood among soldiers that can only be explained as family. Your father is part of our family, and so you are, and your family. Words cannot express how much we feel with the loss of one of our own. Your father's memory lives within each of us, and now that his memory will always be honored by our organization. As a Gold Star family member, the daughter and legacy of Staff Sergeant George Anthony Puglisi, we are pleased to honor your father's service and ultimate sacrifice through you and present you with the 109th Infantry Legacy Scholarship Award. Congratulations.
In September of 2016, our faculty lost a kind and devoted teacher, Mr. Christopher Buckley. The fifth annual Chris Buckley Memorial Bowling Scholarship is presented to a student who has shown the same caring and compassionate characteristics, along with the quick wit that Mr. Buckley exuded throughout his career.
This year's recipient has willingly and enthusiastically offered help to all students, regardless of their physical or intellectual capabilities. We are proud to present the 2021 Chris Buckley Memorial Bowling Scholarship to Raymond Offner.
Good evening and congratulations, class of 2021. My name is Holly Sayre and I'm the superintendent. Unfortunately, Mr. Farrell was unable to join us tonight, so I have the honor of presenting these awards. The Dime Bank most generously offers a $1,000 scholarship each year to a graduating senior in the Wayne Highlands, Wallen-Paulpack, Delaware Valley, and Carbondale area school districts. To be eligible, the applicant must be pursuing a degree in business or a related business major such as accounting, economics, marketing, etc., in an accredited school of higher education. The recipient of the 2021 Dime Bank Director's Award is Aaron McHale. The Ambassador Against Drugs Award, presented on behalf of the Lackawanna County District Attorney's Office, recognizes a student who has consistently put others above herself in educating, assisting, and supporting others in the fight against illicit drug and alcohol use and abuse. This year's recipient of the award is Gianna Arnese. Ross from Feel Good Motors established Feel Good Charities in memory of his parents, Sheila and Bucky Ross, who tragically passed away at the ages of 45 and 49. The scholarship is based on the way his parents lived every day. His parents led by example, by being kind and teaching him to have empathy for others, especially for people in need, even though they also struggled, growing up in a household of 10. As a family, doing random acts of kindness happened quite often, whether it was shoveling a neighbor's driveway, opening a door for a stranger, or just being polite and showing respect for others. Frank said the most important two words his parents taught him were the words thank you. By saying the words thank you, you are showing appreciation, caring, and respect for others. This year, Feel Good Charities had over 150 applications from 15 area high schools. It's amazing how many young adults are showing love and kindness at such an early age. The 2021 Feel Good Charities Being Kind Scholarship goes to Taylor Matza. Rock Family Scholarship was started some years ago in honor of our teachers in this school and the Roosevelt Elementary School. The Fendrocks aren't a wealthy family. They participated in the free lunch program during some of the years they attended Carbondale area. Their award selection process takes into account not only academic achievements, but also family, health, financial, or other hardships applicants face while working towards their achievements. This has been a particularly difficult time for many. The Fendrock family, perhaps like many of yours, faced painful hardships, the death of their father in November of 2019, physical, mental, emotional, financial, and substance abuse challenges, and the loss of many family members and friends. They're still standing, a little wobbly, but standing and looking towards better days. The youngest sister, who in honesty didn't always apply herself academically while she was here, defended her dissertation just a few days ago. She will soon be a doctor of education. This year's scholarship is dedicated to everyone who was lost during this pandemic, and to everyone in this room who might be a bit wobbly, but who is still holding strong. You face the struggles and are here to tell the tale. Congratulations, well done. At the end of such unprecedented time, we're going to do something a little different this year. Although we can only award one scholarship, we would like to recognize all of the applicants and present them with a small token of our congratulations. Recognition goes to Dina Macuso, Sarah Tallarico, Gianna Arnese, this year's scholarship goes to Taylor Matza. Thank you from the Fendrock family. The Kayla Nakaninchny Memorial Scholarship is presented in memory of Kayla, who was a proud graduate of Carbondale area. Kayla's enthusiasm as a Charger was evident through her involvement as a cheerleader, as well as other clubs. Her pride and enthusiasm continued through to her college experience at Penn State's main campus. Just prior to the start of her senior year at Penn State, Kayla was diagnosed with stage 4 brain cancer. Her motto, "Life is tough, but I'm tougher," was part of her drive, determination, and motivation to succeed in spite of that diagnosis. Despite chemotherapy, radiation, and her various other cancer treatments, Kayla, with her positive attitude and bright smile, missed only one college semester. Kayla graduated from Penn State in December 2014 with a Bachelor of Science in Biology. Her ultimate goal was to become a pediatrician and was, in fact, accepted at the Philadelphia College of Osteopathic Medicine. Even though Kayla's life was cut short, she accomplished much and affected many other people's lives in a profound way. She lived her life with enthusiasm, passion, and determination, touching others with her kind and gentle spirit. Congratulations to the class of 2021 and this year's recipient of the Kayla Nakininchny Memorial Scholarship, Sarah Tallarico, a future Nittany Lion. The 13th annual Anne Fedorchak Memorial Scholarship is awarded on behalf of the late Anne Fedorchak, a former teacher and librarian here at Carbondale area for over 25 years. Anne passed away in October 2008 after a courageous battle against pancreatic cancer. Anne was an exceptional educator, librarian, and role model who touched the lives of many. She had a passion for reading, and she instilled that love in her students every day, even as she bravely battled her disease. This memorial scholarship is awarded to the student who has demonstrated academic excellence and leadership to their school or community, and who have served as active members of the library club, where they helped promote Anne's love for reading to the elementary school students. This year's recipient will each be awarded this year's recipient will be awarded a scholarship in the amount of $500. Congratulations to Dina Mancuso. The Timothy Joseph Tirano Memorial Scholarship, recognizing outstanding determination and fortitude, is awarded to Raymond Offner. The Frank T. Lee Citizenship Award Foundation presents its annual award to the student who has demonstrated dedication to the ideals and community activities that characterized the short life of Frank Lee, former administrator of the city of Carbondale. This year's recipient of the $400 award is Amelia Escrow. The Judith and Joseph Calabro Memorial Award is presented in the amount of $500 to the student with the third highest average. This scholarship is awarded to Sarah Tallarico. In recognition of outstanding academic achievement, the Carbondale Area High School faculty presents its Academic Excellence Awards to the following students who have attained the highest five averages in their class. First one, Bailey Brizanti. Second, Aviana Puglisi. Sarah Tallarico. Gianna Arnis. And Olivia Chaffone. The Nellie Jordan and Mary Louise Gallagher Scholarship for Academic Excellence in Community and School Involvement in the amount of $500 is presented to Bailey Brizanti. The Robert Gerbel Scholarship for Outstanding Performance on the Math SAT in the amount of $500 is awarded to Gianna Arnis. My last one I'm up here for is the James Margaret Pigeon Scholarship for Academic Excellence in Community and School Involvement in the amount of $500 is presented to Taylor Mazza.
All right, and a slight break with tradition here. I'm going to pinch hit for Mr. Farrell, as Mrs. Sarah also just did. I have to send out a lot of thank yous tonight. First of all, obviously, to our school board, our administration, Mrs. Sarah, Mr. Farrell. A night that usually seems inevitable that we're going to have this every year was anything but this year. A month ago, if we thought we were going to have this, people would have said you were crazy, and here we are. So on behalf of these students and their families, thank you to the board and the administration. Thank you, of course, as always, to our scholarship benefactors and presenters for supporting these students in their future endeavors. And I have to thank everyone who helped put this night together, most especially Mrs. Alyssa Main and Mrs. Carrie Burrow. Last several days down in the auditorium getting everything set for this. Of course, for all the behind-the-scenes work leading up to this, Mrs. Marissa Durkin, Mrs. Michelle Gerken. Thank you. I have to thank a former faculty member who I'm sure is still watching somewhere, Mr. Tommy Evans, who used to run this with me and continue to support me even this year after he left the school. That's the kind of dedication he had to this district, so thank you to him. Thank you to Mrs. Nicole Rosar for coordinating with CTC these beautiful programs and tickets that we had. I think the nicest ones we've ever had. Mrs. Rosar put that together, and the people at CTC helped us with that, so thank you. Of course, everybody who helped get us set up in the days leading up to this, Mr. Schuster, Mrs. Hulse, Mr. McDonough, Ms. Smith and the maintenance staff setting up the sound, the audio, the stage that we see here tonight. So thank you to all of them. Thank you to all of the other faculty and staff who volunteered here tonight. They did not have to be here. They're here to support your students. So thank you to them. Thank you to the 14 students sitting in this front row who had to bear with me for the last 3 days and put this all together. This is their night, so thank you to them. And last and most importantly, thank you to the parents, the grandparents, the guardians, the aunts, the uncles, everyone who's taken part in this. This was an incredibly challenging year for everyone. I know we didn't want to dwell on that too much, but thank you for the support you've given your students, which has made our jobs much easier in this difficult year. So thank you to all of you, and congratulations.
Looking back on our years at CAHS as Chargers and Chargerettes, it seems like our journey here is not actually coming to an end. It feels like yesterday when we were all in seventh grade learning our locker combinations or sitting in Mr. Perry's class educating ourselves on the Mojave Desert tortoises. Although we are all about to embark on various journeys, this class will always cherish the memories we have made together. We, the class of 2021, would like to give a big thank you to all the people who have made everything possible for us this year and in all years past. Thank you to the teachers who pushed us to our best potential, the faculty who fought for us to have a wonderful high school experience, the family who supported us along the way, and the friends who made it all worth it. Tonight is one of our last nights walking through these halls, but even when we're gone, our Charger pride will never die.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much.